Hi, I'm Eran from SternFX, and in this tutorial, I'll show you how to create stunning 3D smoke effects from VDB files in After Effects using Helium. This tutorial is based on Helium, which is a 3D motion design plugin for After Effects that allows you to create 3D titles, import 3D models, create terrain, procedural noise effects, cloners, and much more. You can download a free trial and find out more at heliumx.tv. Now, if you're new to Helium, I recommend that you'll watch my previous tutorial where I'm going through the basics and showing you how to import 3D models and create extruded text. The link is in the description. In this tutorial, I want to focus on the volume render feature that allows you to work with VDB files, also known as volumetric data blocks, to add realistic 3D smoke. So first, let's review this comp that I set up ahead of time before importing those VDB files. Over here, I'm using a still image from Adobe Stock, and there are links to everything that I'm using in the description below. Above this layer, there's the Helium layer, which is just a solid that I've named Helium, and I already imported the teacup model, as well as created a floor and a title. Then I've added four lights to light the scene. Some of the lights, by the way, are animated to add more drama to the title. And this main spotlight is the only one that casts shadows. All of the nulls that you are seeing here were generated automatically by Helium. And I'm using the teacup null to rotate the cup just to give it a bit more appeal. Above all, there's a camera that dollies slowly towards us to add movement to this otherwise static 3D scene. There's also an audio layer here in the bottom of the timeline, and I'll turn it on towards the end, so make sure to stick around to hear what it has to offer. But that's about it for my setup. Again, if you are new to this plugin and this looks a little bit overwhelming, make sure to watch my beginner's tutorial as well as few others that you can find at heliumx.tv. But now we are ready to start. Now, there are a couple of websites that offers free VDB sequences, and I've included one of them in the description below. But the thing is that most of these free sequences are short, probably due to the fact that these files are quite large and heavy. So for this 10 seconds comp that I have, I will use two assets from the animated smoke pack volume 1 and 2, courtesy of the Pixel Lab. Now, I must tell you that they are not sponsoring this video. I just think that this is a great resource for this kind of stuff. If you haven't heard about the Pixel Lab, make sure to check their website, look at their products page, and check also the freebies section. They have tons of 3D models, fantastic tutorials, and very cool stuff to help you be a more efficient 3D artist and motion designer. Okay, so after this long buildup, let's see how this works. I'll select the Helium layer over here, and then I'll go to Effect, Helium, and add a volume. I'll rename my volume. I'm just going to add the word tornado, so I'll know what it does. And then I'll click on Import Volume, navigate to the folder that I have the VDB sequence. I'm using Smoke 65 from the Smoke Pack Volume 2. And I'll click open. This is going to bring it over here to the timeline, and it's also going to create a null object for it. Now, in this case, it is very small. It is there, but we can't see it. I'm just going to scrub the timeline and maybe you can pick it up, but just to make sure that we can see it properly, I'll twirl down the properties section, and I happen to know that I need to change the size here to 3500, and this is going to show up over here. So if I go to the beginning and start to scrub the timeline, you can see how this works. Now, this sequence is longer than what I need, and I actually want some movement at the beginning of this composition. So I'll grab the Smoke VDB sequence, and I'm just going to change it so it will end with my timeline, something like this. And this means that here in the beginning of the comp, we will already have something which is animating and moving. Now, I just want to illustrate that this is living inside a unified 3D space of Helium. So to demonstrate this, I'll switch to Custom View 1, and here I can grab the Tornado Null. So let's just name this instead of Smoke Null, Tornado. And I'm also going to take the footage itself and bring it under everything. I'll change the label to Cyan. These are all the sources that Helium is referencing. And then I'll return to this Tornado Null, and I can start to move this tornado and bring it inside the teacup, something like this. And this is really useful because you can use those nulls to control and animate the 3D objects in a very easy way. I'll drag it under the camera, and then I'll switch back to my active camera so I can see what I'm doing. I'll press P and then Shift S and maybe also Shift R. This is going to expose the position, scale, orientation, and rotation properties of this null. I happen to know that this one wants to be in a 7 degrees orientation. And this is because I changed the orientation of the teacup. I just want them to match. And then I'll animate the scale. I'll start from 30% at the start of the composition, create the keyframe, and then go to the end and scale it back to 100. Maybe even bigger. Let's go with 105. But we can see that we have things which are popping out of the teacup. So let's fix this. I'll create a keyframe for the position over here, and I'll raise it on its y-axis and maybe also push it on its z-axis. So something like this should work. Then let's check it at the beginning. We may want to move it so it will be in the middle of the cup, maybe a bit more closer to us. Notice that Helium is rendering the shadows automatically inside the teacup, as well as on the desk over here, which is, of course, the floor. Already, this looks very promising, but now we need to edit the materials. So for that, I'll select the Helium layer, and we can click on Edit. And this is going to show us a few built-in volume materials that we can use or customize. So you can go with smoke and fire, explosion, smoke heavy. And I'm just clicking on this to show you the different things that you can apply to those VDBs. Of course, you can have access to all the individual materials if you want, but my recommendation is to start with one of them and then customize it over here inside After Effects. So I'll click Apply for the fire. It's a bit exaggerated because I don't think that Tornado has so much fire inside, but we can customize the three most important ingredients, the density, emission, and absorption. Now, if you want access to everything, you can check this material option on and click on the arrow over here. And this is going to show you the volume material. And over here, you can control everything independently. Specifically, you can set the emission color gradient. So you have a lot of control. Now, if you're working like this, make sure that you'll take the volume and the volume material and place them above everything else. So Helium is going to render them first and not affect all the other objects that you have in this scene. But in this example, I'm just going to switch it off, and then I'll delete this one and just use those three things to control the way this is looking. So first I'll change the density to a higher number. This controls the smoke amount. So I'll set it to 2000. And then for the emission, I'll lower it to 1000. And for the absorption, I'll set it to 100. Now I came to those numbers by trial and error, but I think it will look better if we're going to colorize them a bit differently. So I'll start with the emission color. I'm just going to click over here to sample something from the scene. And I'm also going to click on the color for the density. Remember, this is the color for the smoke. And I'll set the hue to 45, the saturation to 13, and the brightness to 50. Let's preview this composition from the beginning. Wow, I think it looks great. Very convincing, but maybe we can make it even better. And by better, I mean to add maybe another atmospheric smoke behind the teacup. Now, currently, we can't add more than one volume render to the same helium layer. Maybe this will change in the future, but as a workaround, I'm going to create a separate layer and add the smoke to it. This means that this layer won't interact with the main helium layer, but it will still respond to all the 3D attributes in this comp, such as lights, cameras, and other 3D layers. Okay, so I'll go to the layer menu and create a new solid. I'll name this one helium-smoke. Make sure it is set to the comp size, of course, and click OK. And this one is going to be behind our main helium layer. I'll go to effect, and then under helium, I'll add a volume render. I'll click on import volume, and this one is smoke 22 from the animated smoke pack volume 1 from the Pixel Lab, of course. I'll click open to bring it into the scene. I know it's very small, so we can't see it. So let's open up the properties and change the size to 5,000. We still can't see anything. So let's scrub the timeline. And over here, we can see our smoke. Okay, I'm going to do some housekeeping first. I'll take the VDB sequence, place it underneath all the other layers, and change the label color to cyan. And just to keep things organized, I'll also take the null, name it smoke null, so know what this one is doing. Then press P, and I'm just going to plug in some values that I know will work. So 200 for the X, 960 for the Y and the Z. And this is going to place it just where I want it to be, behind the teacup over here. Now let's modify the appearance a bit. So I'll select the helium smoke layer. This time, I'm not going to touch anything over here because by default, it is bringing it as a nice smoke renderer. But I will change the blending mode from normal to screen. And I think I'm also going to press T and lower the opacity. Let's go with 70%. I'll check it in a few other places. And as you can see, this adds a nice atmospheric smoke to everything behind it. Now, as a result, the shadows look a little bit dimmed. So the last touch here is to darken the shadows, especially towards the end of the composition. And a cool way to achieve it is to add an empty helium layer, or in other words, a helium comp effect. This adds an entire helium setup from another layer or comp and allows you to easily construct complex scene in a modular way without cluttering your project. But I'm going to use it as a hack to multiply the shadows. So over here, I'll create another new solid. I'll call it darker shadows. And then drag it under all the helium layers. I'll go to effect now, and then from the helium category, I'll add the helium comp effect. Now I'll tell the helium comp effect to use the main helium as the comp layer. And as a result, if I'll turn on and off this layer, you can see that I'm darkening the shadows. And as a bonus, I'm also getting some extra smoke at the edge of this tornado. Now this works perfectly over here at the last frame, but it will create two darker shadows at the beginning. So I'll press T and animate the opacity. I'll start with a value of 0 at the start of this composition, then go over here to the end and set it to 100. And this is just going to help us bring more of a contact shadows as well as shadows over here on the table. And of course, this is up to taste, so you can add more or less depending on how much darker you want your shadows to be. And as a final touch, I'll go to the layer menu and create an adjustment layer, making sure this one is above everything. I'll rename it glow because you guessed it. I'm going to add the glow effect from the stylized category. So here it is. I'll change the settings of the glow to 50% for the threshold, 200% for the glow radius, and 0.3 for the glow intensity. Now, this is still too much, so I'll change the glow colors from original to A and B colors, and then I'll sample a light blue color for color A, and for color B, I'll go with something from the table. And this is just going to help to connect everything together, I think, a bit more nicer. And that's it. We are ready to go to the last layer over here, which is the audio layer that has some tornado storm sound effects. So I'll switch it on and then I'll maximize the composition and preview the final result. So this is it. I think it looks amazing and was relatively easy to achieve. I love the fact that we don't need to know how to create these complex 3D simulations, and most importantly, we didn't need to leave After Effects to comp everything together. If you haven't used Helium, give it a try, as I think it can be your best VFX and MoGraph buddy.